What's up, everybody? It's your main man, Eddie from EM Performance, and we are back with some more content for you guys. Wanted to chime in real quick for you guys. Just doing some little odds and ends stuff. Little advice for you guys out there, whether you're running Boost or not, and you have an older build, that you've hand built yourself, or you've done a lot of stuff yourself as far as, modifications and part changes, upgrades, things of that nature. You should always take time to go through your car, tighten things up, make sure everything is secure. One thing I'm doing here, which I wanted to show you guys, is, a little preventative maintenance. If you find something that you don't feel too sure about that could pose a problem in the future, you want to address that right away. Don't let it go to that point where something actually does happen. So yeah, just make sure you guys take time. This, I got this tip from a drag racer. They go through their car, each time that they race, and sometimes we forget as, spirited drivers or, part-time track racers, to go through your car, make sure your lug nuts are tight, make sure your exhaust bolts are tight, your suspension bolts, all of the general stuff, because there's a lot of moving components in these vehicles, and if you miss one thing, that could, could be catastrophic, or it could cause, minor failures as well too. But what I wanted to show you guys today, I did find something. I have a wire, it's a power wire, running underneath, across, it's my positive terminal, battery wire, and it's running across, the front of the engine, and it's covered, but I did find a small spot, where it's open, and it is covered in a plastic sheath, somewhat, so to speak, but I wanted to feel a little bit better and get something to, be able to handle higher temperatures, because, I am running a turbo now, and heat is a destroyer, so you got to be very careful. The amount of heat that comes from turbo superchargers and, the hot sides of the exhaust in these builds can melt your wires quicker than you can blink an eye. So I went out and I grabbed some of this. This is something quick and easy to do. And these are for small, very small, protections, if you will. But I do recommend, if you're going to wrap something, wrap it in heat sheath, DEI makes that as well. I did that for my fuel lines inside the engine bay, but I just found a very small area, and I think this is perfect for what I need. And I'm just going to wrap that power wire in this cool tape. And this cool tape here, it's good up to 400 degrees Fahrenheit of direct heat, and protects up to 2000 Fahrenheit in radiant heat, meaning the heat that radiates from that item. So whereas this power wire is somewhat close to my driver's hot side, the header, I said, I don't want anything to happen to it in the future. Nothing has happened to it now. I just kind of look ahead, and I try to, think about these hot summer days. I'm sitting there in traffic. It's idling. The temperature's at peak, and that wire, is, could be 4 or 5 inches, 4 inches away, 3 inches, whatever it may be. That radiant heat can get up there, and you don't want that melting that wire and then causing you to be stranded. Then you need a tow truck, blah, blah, blah. You know the deal. So $20, you can go down, AutoZone, Pep Boys, whatever's easier for you, pick this up, wrap those wires up, and give yourself a peace of mind, and you won't be spending that extra money down the road. So I hope this guy, I hope this helped you guys out. And if you're not subscribed already, hit the subscribe button at the bottom, because I plan on posting some awesome content here for you guys, including all my live Instagram feeds, which are on here too. So if you have a favorite that you'd like to see interviewed on Instagram Live, shoot me a message, leave a message below, whatever you want to do, reach out to me. I'll make that happen. I hope you guys have a great day. Stay safe, and I'll talk to you soon.